Something about the Politecnico. The Politecnico di Milano was founded in 1863, so 153 years ago. Many technical university. It is a technical university, which means we have schools only of engineering, architecture, design. And the majority of a technical university is in Europe were founded in a narrow time window, the Industrial Revolution. And the Politecnico was founded under the pressure of a new born companies, industries that needed a university to cooperate with. Okay. Oh, that's just curiosity. The logo of the Politecnico comes from the right-hand side detail of the School of Athens by Raphael. In Milano, we have the big drawing of the School of Athens. And it's the lecture of geometry, Euclides demonstrating a theorem. The name Politecnico di Milano is the brand name, but nowadays we are not only in Milano. We have a network. We have two campuses in Milano. One in Como, one in Lecco, Cremona, Mantova, even one in Piacenza, which is in another region. Some information. Why we are so spread? The north of Italy is the most industrialized part of the country, but different from east to west. If you start east here, there is micro-industry, family-owned industries with 3-4 workmen, no more. Thousands and thousands of them. On the west, Torino, Piemonte, the Fiat, big industries and subsidiaries. Lombardy is the most developed industrial region based mainly on small and medium-sized industries. These are the kind of industries that need to have a university close. They don't go to for a consultancy 1,000 kilometers apart or 200. That's why our philosophy, we have all the kind of engineering, architecture, and design in Milano, in the two campuses, while the other campuses have only those kind of subjects that are relevant to the local industry. Some images, that's the rectorate, that's an image of the other campus. The other campus in Milano is in an industrial dismissed area. So we have there the big infrastructures, research infrastructure. I will tell you something in a moment. That's Como, Lecco, Cremona, Piacenza, Mantova. Some numbers. As you see, we have many, many students in engineering, in architecture, and in design. We are by far the largest one. We are graduating 21% of all the architects of Italy, 16% of all the engineers, and 42% of the designers. We have almost the monopoly of design, because it's Milan. But even with this 16%, that's the largest school of engineering in Italy. But there are many, many schools of engineering in Italy. Some numbers, you could not be interested in that. Oh, in information about rankings of university, the QS ranking done in London puts us this year number one in Italy in our fields, obviously, in science and technology, number 7th in Europe and number 24th in the world. Oh, here are. But companies are appreciating very much. In the same ranking, the appreciation of company, so that was the appreciation of a school. This is the appreciation of a product, of you when you come out. How the companies appreciate the engineers that come out of the Politecnico di, or architects that come out of the Politecnico di Milano. In Europe, the companies put us in various fields, number 4, number 6, number 5, number 4. And so on. For example, in mathematics, we are number 8, but we don't have a school of mathematics. We have only a department, but even with that department, we are number 8 in Europe. Okay, let's skip that. It's quite an international university. These are the number of students, not exchange students. On these numbers, you have to add students like you that come for an exchange. These are the students who come to the Politecnico to follow the complete course. So foreigners that decide to do the study at the Politecnico. And so you see, in bachelor, only 5%, because we teach the bachelor in Italian. But we teach master and PhD, mostly 92%, in English. And so we have 22% of the students at the master level are foreigners, and almost one third of the PhD are foreigners. Let's skip. Oh, framework agreement, you cannot be interested. Oh, that's a little bit of propaganda. We had only one, so we like to show Professor Natta, who in 63 won the Nobel Prize for the discovery of the catalysis of polymers, so the invention of the polymers. Here is when he received the Nobel Prize. And on the top of that, we have Aldo Rossi and Renzo Piano, who received the Pritzker in architecture, which is the equivalent of a Nobel for architecture. Oh, some honorary degrees, the structure, let's keep it. That's important, how we are organized educationally. We have 13 years of education before entering university. 13. 1 year more than most of the world. So 5 years of elementary, 3 of junior high, 5 years of high school, which amounts to 13 before entering university. So students are freshmen when they are 19 years old. They enter Politecnico di Milano 19 years old. Then we have a bachelor in 3 years. Since we have so long an education, here in the 3 years we have only, for example, in engineering, only courses in science, technology. We don't teach history or other things. It has already, or sociology, it has already been done here. Plus a master, we call it laurea magistrale, master of science, in 2 years, plus 3 years minimum for a PhD. It's not the end of the story. There are other 2 products, but you may not be interested to that. Instead of doing the laurea magistrale, these are vocational courses. They're addressed particularly to some industries. And you see, the main track, the color track for the Italian students is heavily financed by the government. The students pay, but much less than the real cost. We divide students in 10 ranges of family income. The poor one don't pay anything, is totally free, but even rich ones who don't produce any document to have discount pay 1/3 of the real cost. So the maximum which is paid at the Politecnico is 3,600 euros, and the real cost is 3 times paid by the government. But this applies only to the main track. These other 2 products, the students have to pay the real cost. But in the majority of cases, these are employees of companies sent by the companies to us, and the companies are paying for these modules. So they don't pay on their own. Oh, programs in English. The bachelors are mainly in Italian. The masters, as you see, are in English. Here there is a long list. It's easier to say what we do not have. We do not have marine naval engineering. We are not on the sea. We do not have mining. Mining lost relevance in Italy. We have all the other fields, all classical or very new. We cover everything in engineering, architecture, design, except those 2 fields. You see, you have architecture, you have building engineering, you have sustainable architecture, urban planning. Bachelor in design, master in design. Then, School of Civil Engineering. Here we have the head of your department of civil engineering and a postdoc of ours who is here in that field. So they could answer many of your questions better than me. We have civil engineering, civil and environmental and land planning engineering. And master, these are the masters in that field. Interesting, civil, very interesting, very modern risk mitigation. We have a good school of risk theory for complex system. A lot of mathematics in it. That's the school of what we call industrial and information engineering. In English is a bad name because it means a different thing. You know, in France, Italy, Spain, by industrial we means related to industry. Is what you call management, what we call management. For you, industrial is what we call management and production. There is a difference of terminology. Okay, for us, industrial is this. These are the bachelors and these are the masters. You see aeronautical, automation, biomedical. That's very, very modern. Biomedical for neurosensorial systems, prosthesis, growing of tissues on polymeric scaffoldings, these kind of things. But also biomedical engineering for sports. Chemical, computer, electrical. By electrical, we mean power, electricity. Electronics, energy, including nuclear energy, but there is also nuclear energy separate. Management engineering, materials and nanotechnology. Mathematical engineering is a very transversal course. Lot of mathematics, lot of mathematical modeling, statistics, financial mathematics, game theory. It's quite difficult, but the graduates are very appreciated. They are doing the least to hire them. Particularly the financial institutes, the insurances, banks. Mechanical, nuclear, safety and prevention in process industry, Space Engineering, Telecommunication. These were the masters. And then the PhD, the same, more or less the same fields, with those two exceptions. We have an Alta Scuola Politecnica, let's keep that. Placement and graduation. Okay, that's interesting because that's not the case in Italy usually. We are unique in that. Unfortunately for the rest of Italy, I'm not proud of that as an Italian, that only us have these good numbers. That is, in 2 months, one half of a graduate have already a permanent position, 88 in 6 months. In engineering, 90.7 have a permanent job after 6 months. The datum in Italy is much lower. We have a career service to help students find jobs. These are the departments, but you are not interested in it. Some research, okay, let's keep research. We have laboratories, interdepartmental laboratories that are, let's say, the jewel of the crown, the most important ones. One is the wind tunnel. For low velocity, for civil engineering, at the moment is the largest in the world. We can test models 13 meters long, turning them around in the wind. We have a laboratory for safety of transport, crash test laboratory. A big laboratory for structures, micro and nanotechnology, MOOCs, mathematical modeling. They have been very successful in the last years, mainly in two fields, sports. They have a lot of contracts from producers of boats, of instruments for sports, to maximize the efficiency. Just as a curiosity, when they told me, I was laughing, thinking that it was a joke, and it was true. They got an important contract to study the drag of the water on the Olympic swimsuit, to do the mathematical model, because a fraction of a second can make a difference. CUSBO is for ultra-fast laser pulses. I told you, in sports, and the other field is biomedical engineering. For example, together with EPFL in Lausanne, the two huge groups of mathematicians worked already for 10 years, and it will take over 10 years, more or less. They are doing the complete mathematical model of all the circulation of the blood in the brain. So that at the end, there will be a software on a computer, a surgeon will know, if I put a stent here, what will happen of a vorticosity here in the brain? It's a huge, huge problem. That's a cooperation together with Zurich on the nanotechnology of the surfaces of the chips for the computers. And Polyfactory, some startups, companies started by former students of the Politecnico. Okay, let's keep that. We have consortia with companies. We have a foundation. The last born initiative is that to create in our students social responsibility. It's promoting actions to have graduate with social responsibility. Okay. I will show with another file what we can do for in our exchange. This one. Okay. So now, already for some year, we have an agreement between our two universities whereby you can do a double degree. That is a project, a curriculum, whereby at the end of the day you get two full-fledged independent degrees, one by Uninorte and one by Politecnico. Both of them will be not distinguishable from one given to local students. So the title you will obtain by the Politecnico di Milano will be exactly the same as the one we award to our students. No difference. The two possible, just to clarify the ideas, because you will hear around speaking of double degrees and of joint degrees. That's the definition we use. Double degree project is what we have with your university. As I told you, the final product are two independent degrees, obviously requiring some extra workload. A joint is something different, we don't have that, is a single document, a single degree, where the two universities are the providers. So is a single degree with the logos of the two universities. What I am proposing you here is a double, not a joint. Oh, here is what I remind you of this scheme. So you have to remember mainly that we have 3 years of bachelor and 2 years of master's after 1 year more before entering university. So here they enter 19 year old. It took 3 years to get a laurea and then 2 years to get the master. First scheme. After 4 years, you come to the Politecnico for only 1 year. 1 year. And you get il titolo professionale della Uninorte and the laurea triennale, the bachelor, of the Politecnico di Milano, staying with us only 1 year. That's one scheme. The other scheme, these are schemes that have been signed between the two universities, so when you live in one of the schemes, you are certain that it will be recognized by that. The second scheme is that you do the 4 years here, then you come to the Politecnico, you don't do, in the previous one, you see, in the previous one, you entered in the third year. Here. Now, you don't enter here, but you enter 1 year later, and you stay for 2 years with us. But at the end of the day, you have a titolo professionale della Uninorte and our Master of Science. As our students, exactly. It doesn't mention that it has been done in cooperation with Uninorte or with another university. Is our title, the usual full-fledged title. These are the schemes that we are proposing. But now what is important is to hear your question, and together with you, perhaps you could come out, the two of you, we can answer together to the questions. And is a postdoc, but well, much more close in time to the student than I am. So we can answer different questions. The problem, okay, in these schemes we do not have scholarships, but what we do is that we do the total fee waiver. You don't pay anything at the Politecnico, but you have to maintain yourself. That's the problem. In the afternoon we will speak, but we have almost nothing left in the project sustainability we had, but we already used all the remain something just quickly in case some of you is interested to come in the afternoon for that. The grants that remain are mainly for the so-called target group 3, so either people that are or indigenous or with political refugees, political asylum, something documented. We still have something for them, but only for them.
Okay. Is it becas? So, no hay una beca como tal, pero no tienes que pagar matrícula. Solo puedes considerar como una beca.
Sí.
Él cuando dice que no hay una beca es porque en Estados Unidos y en Europa, cuando se habla de becas, se acostumbra que no solamente te pagan la matrícula, sino que también te dan sostenimiento para que tú vivas. Acá te dan la matrícula, pero no te dan sostenimiento.
Let's say I want to join the program of 4 years here and 2 years in Laurea Magistrale. What about a time for business practice or professional practices? Will there be some in the program? Or?
We have a placement office. When you arrive, you have to contact them to enroll there, to give your name, and they will come out with some offer of internship at the company. You have to do it immediately because the students are so many, but there are opportunities.
Hay oportunidades, pero yo creo que aquí es como obligatorio hacer una.
Depende del programa.
Okay. Normalmente. No, eso. Al Politécnico no es algo que es obligatorio, es algo que uno hace como adjuntivo, como más. Pero normalmente no son solo de exámenes.
So, the process for double degree or master's, the thing is we get the degree here and then we apply, or before we get the degree we apply, or how do
we have to apply now.
So before, I get
before,
degree,
before,
and then
before, yes, yes, and at the international office, they are very knowledgeable because there has been a lot of experience in the last years. So you are not the first ones to come. We received 10th of your of students from Uninorte, and we are very very happy of them. We appreciated them. Do you already have that?
What?
No.
She already has.
She already has.
The bachelor.
Ah, the bachelor. You already have a bachelor.
The bachelor in university.
But did you begin the master or not?
No.
No. Well, you can come for the 2 years.
Okay.
Of master.
Or did only.
So you, sorry. So you did 5 years already?
Yes.
It depends on you. For you, it would mean 7 years, five plus two. It depends on you if you are interested, but for us, it's okay.
We only have to do 2 more years.
2 more years, yes.
For the double degree in the last year, we studied in the Polytechnic. Is it in English or in Italian?
Which
for the double degree?
Which engineering?
Industrial.
in you can find it in English. Yes. Yes. But for you, for, by the way, this is done mainly for people coming from strange, from countries that have difficult languages, but between Italian and Spanish, at your age, it's very easy. In 15 days, you speak Italian, being mother tongue Spanish. It's better to apply before.
Before.
To do that sufficiently in time, for many reasons. Not the last one is accommodation, because we have accommodation at reduced price, subsidized by us and so on, but not enough for everyone. So it's important to apply in time. We have many, but not sufficient. Otherwise, you have to go on the free market, and it's more expensive.
For the Dolby, you have the requirement of the language, or just the English is okay for the Dolby?
But if you look on the web, you find what is already in English. And as I told you, 92% is in English. Or completely in English, or courses where you can choose English or Italian. Only 8%, but mainly in architecture, are only in Italian. Well, biomedical engineering has some courses in Italian and the majority in English with some courses in Italian. But as I told you, for example, entering biomedical, where the majority of courses are in English, the moment you have to follow the course in Italian, you already know Italian. And here is a case, the opposite one, of an Italian. I think you can tell, she lives in Spanish.
No,